So we continue with the atomic structure, and we had studied that how the atomic the electrons are placed in the orbits. Now we will take some examples. Now as such in the textbook they have given you the examples of the first 20 elements of the periodic table. So accordingly you got the figure of hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, everything. But what we'll do is that there's no need for going through all of them one by one, because it's having the same kind of a fundamental principle of drawing it. So what I'll do is that I'll go one by one if you want me, but in a continuous manner. So I'll do one thing, that I'll show you this way, that if I take the first element, so that is hydrogen. So we see over here that is hydrogen. The number of protons is 1, and the electrons is also 1, and the neutrons is 0. So this is the first condition. We're not required to write this thing as such. So over here we know that it is the protons present over here, and then there is only one electron which will be there like this. So this is the hydrogen atom. Okay, this is the hydrogen atom. The next one we are having will be the helium atom. So helium will be having 2 protons, 2 electrons, and 2 neutrons. So this will be 2 protons, 2 neutrons, and accordingly 2 electrons. So this will be the structure of the helium atom. Then comes the lithium. So lithium will be over here as the number of protons. Now of course we can easily find out the number of protons and also by the atomic mass number and the atomic number. So the mass number given is a 7, and so that's why, and the is 3, so it's 3, 3, and 4, because the atomic number is, so here the atomic, I'll just write the atomic mass number. So this is the atomic mass number A. Over here is 1, here it is 4, and here it is 7. Right? Lithium, so this will be one more orbit coming up, because it has already completed the two of the first orbit. So that will be the lithium. The next one is beryllium, having the atomic mass is now, so it is Be, beryllium, which will be having the 4, 4, and 5, because 4 protons, 4 electrons, and 4 plus 9 minus 4 is 5 neutrons. So here it will be this way, that the protons will be 4, neutrons will be 5, and the electrons will be, we'll take them together, so 2 electrons here, so it will be 4 electrons. Right? The next one is boron. So boron is 11, so this will be 5, 5, and 6. So this will give you as 5 protons, 6 neutrons, and there will be 2, 3, that is 5 electrons. Okay, so we have over here, this is I'll just write the electronic configuration also. So it will be 1, this will be 2, this will be 1, 2, 1, this is 2, 2, this is 2, 3. Okay. After boron comes the next one, that is carbon. So carbon, the value is 12, so this is 6, 6, 6, and 2, 4. So that will be, this will be 6, this will be 2 electrons like this. Okay, I just skipped some in between, so I'll go directly now to the, ye hai 6 na, so 7 and 8 are nitrogen and oxygen. So oxygen will be 2, 5, and 2, nitrogen will be 2, 5, and 2, 6 will be oxygen. And then it will be fluorine and neon. So fluorine, neon directly like that. So neon is Ne, is neon, which has got 20 over here. So this is 10th number. So 10, 10, and 10, and this is going to be 2, 8. So the neon will be like this, that it will be 10 protons, 10 neutrons, and 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 7, 8, 9, 10. So this will be the 10 electrons, so 2, 8. The next one will be sodium. So sodium will be 23, so it will be 11, 11, and 12. So it will be 2, 8, 1, because it's 11. So there will be over here 11, this will be 12, and one more orbit will be required to give you, sorry, this is slightly bad. one more orbit will be required, which will make this thing as 1 year. So this will be 2, 8, 1. So this is the electronic configuration, like this. Okay. Again, we will skip some of them and we come directly to chlorine, because the next one is exactly the same. 2, 8, 2, 8, 3, 2, 8, 4, 2, 8, 5. ऐसे करके सभी elements for 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 ऐसे चलते रहेंगे. 17 का देखते हैं. 17 is year is 35, so it is 17, 17 and 18, and the configuration will be here with 2, 8, 7. So it will be 17 protons, 18 neutrons, and there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 electrons as the outermost shell. The next one is argon. So argon will be given as argon, the number is 40. So that's why it is 18, 18 and 22. Okay, 18, 18 and 22 neutrons, because 40 minus 18 is 22. So the configuration will be 2, 8, 8. So 2 plus 8 is 10, plus 8 is 18. So that will be, this will become a example of, this is now argon. Okay, so that is argon. Now we see two more. So the first one is potassium. The potassium, the mass over here is 39. So that is 19, 19 and 20. So this will be 2, 8, 8, 1, because after this you cannot have the 9. See, the third orbit over here has got the capacity 18, but due to the duplet rule and octet rule, we cannot have more than 8 in the last orbit, and that's why we need to increase an orbit over here, and this increased orbit will be having 1 electron outside. This will be 2, 8, 8, 1. So that is the electronic configuration for potassium. And then finally one is calcium. So Ca calcium, that is atomic number is 40. It's 20, 20, 20, 2, 8, 8, 2. So that will be just one more electron in the outermost shell. So this way you are going to draw the different atomic structures from hydrogen to calcium. So the first 20 elements, you are going to draw the atomic structures, because they may ask you the atomic structures of any of them. Now if you are given the atomic number and the atomic mass number and you are asked to draw this thing, so you can be easily drawing it. Like for example, if you take the example of say calcium, they will give you the atomic number 17 and atomic mass number 35. So you know that because the atomic number is 17, so protons are 17, electrons are 17, and the number of neutrons will be 35 minus 17, so 18. And because it's 17 electrons, so 7 electrons will be distributed in the form of 2, 8, 7, and hence you will be drawing such a figure over here with this thing. So that is how you will be drawing. Now another important thing will be that these electrons will be drawn in a particular manner. So this electrons will have to be like this with a negative sign inside. So all these electrons will be like this. So I forgot to tell you earlier. So this is negative sign inside. So there's a negative here, negative here, negative, negative here. This is going to be negative charge, 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 negative charge. Okay, so this is how you're going to draw the electrons as negative charges over here. So in case the school tells you not to draw a negative charge, it's fine enough, but I don't want to lose marks unnecessarily just because you have not put a negative sign over there. So that's why I just told you that you can draw it with negative signs there. So this is about the first 20 elements. Now the first 20 elements ka jab ye kiya hai, to the atomic number and the atomic mass number not only tells you the electronic configuration, but it tells you also something extra. What is that? Now the atomic shells, you will see that the number of electrons present in the last orbit, okay, the number of electrons present in the last orbit are called as valence electrons. So the valence electrons are the one which are going to make it happen ke kitna atom, kitne number of hydrogen atoms will be required to combine with it to form into a compound. So the sharing the of electrons or the give and take of electrons, they are going to take place depending upon the valence electrons. Each and every atom has got a tendency to attain a stable state by reaching 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Of course, the first one, then it'll lead to. But if it is any other shell other than the first one, then the atom will have a tendency to reach 8 electrons in that shell. Now, to reach the 8 electrons, like for example, here okay, the atom, so how can it reach 8? It needs 6. So can it get 6? No, it cannot get 6. So in that case, what will it do? It will give away these 2 electrons. So if the electrons are 1, valence electrons are 1, 2 or 3, they will be donating their electrons. Okay, they will be giving away their electrons, and those elements which give away their electrons are basically called as metals. So the metals are the ones which are going to give away electrons. Okay, if the number of electrons are 5, 6 or 7, they will accept electrons. So the one which is going to accept electrons, they are will be non-metals. So non-metals accept electrons because they are going to take in electrons 1, 2 or 3 into their orbits. So accordingly, they will be, the valency over there will be negative 1, 2, 3. So let's see over here, valency over here. So we can see the valency. So valency over here, in this case, the hydrogen can either give away that one or accept one. That is why it is called as plus or minus 1. Helium does not require anything, so it is 0 because it is not. So if the valency is 0, that means it has already attained its stable state. Any particular atom which has got its outermost shell complete with either 2 or 8, then it is called as a stable atom. And that stable atoms, these are the ones, the naturally occurring stable atoms, they are called as inert gases or noble gases. So helium is a noble gas or an inert gas. Okay, so it's a noble gas. So helium is a noble gas. Whereas this could be metal, can be considered to be metal or non-metal. Why is metal or non-metal? Because it can either give away electron or it can accept electron. Because it is able to do both of them, that is why it can be considered to be as a metal, as well as it could be considered in the case of non-metals. In lithium, it is going to give away electrons, it will be plus 1, hence it is a metal. This is plus 2, that will be a metal. This is plus 3, so it will be a metal. Now over here, it will be, can get 4 or give away 4, so it will be plus or minus 4. And in such a case, here the only difference is that boron is not a metal, but it is a metalloid. Because it has got the property of both metal as well as non-metal, that's why it is called as a metalloid. The 4 one is a non-metal, that is carbon over here is a non-metal, so it is non-metal. Again, this is 0, so noble gas. Over here again, 1 plus 1 metal. This is minus 1, because it's 7, so it is minus 1, so it is non-metal. This is 0, so it is noble gas. This is plus 1, this is plus 2, both will be metals. So as I told you, if it is plus 1, 2 or 3, it will be a metal. If it is minus 1, 2 or 3, it will be a non-metal. If it is 0, it is a noble gas. And then there are certain exceptions over here, like the silicon and the boron. The silicon and boron are metalloids. Silicon has got a valency of 4, whereas the boron has got a valency of plus 3. So boron and silicon are metalloids. All others will be identified as metals and non-metals based on its structure. So there is one more thing over here. In case of phosphorus, they are given that the phosphorus may, the valency is minus 3, and then they are given over here minus 3 or 5. This is because phosphorus, sometimes they have the habit of accepting this way. So it is like You can consider it that have got double valency, 3 as well as 5, because phosphorus is going to form into a compound by multiple number of atoms. So it is P8, you know, it is a one where P is going to be 8 such atoms combining together. That's the reason it has got this bracket with 3 of phylica, because it has a 2 valencies, 3 as well as 5. So this was about how you can, what you can do about from atomic number and atomic mass. So if I know the atomic number and the atomic mass number, first thing what I can do is I can find out the number of protons, number of electrons and number of neutrons. The next I can know is the electronic configuration. Based on electronic configuration, I can draw the atomic structure. The third I can know is from the electronic structure, electronic configuration, I can know the valence electrons, and the valence electron will tell you the valency. If the valency is 1, 2 or 3 positive, it is a metal. If it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, that is, it will be a non-metal. If it is 4 also, it will be non-metal. If it is 0, then it is a noble gas. So this is how you can identify these many things. So we can identify the nature of the element, that is a metal, non-metal, noble gas. We can identify the valency, valence shells, the protons, the electrons and neutrons, knowing the atomic number and atomic mass number. So these are the things what you can identify. So there could be a question in your examination wherein they will give you the atomic number and the atomic mass number, and they can ask you to find out the number of protons, electrons, neutrons, also find out the electronic configuration, the valence shells, the valence shells, whether the metal or non-metal. You can even ask to be identify that particular element, because you know the first 20 elements. So atomic number is 17, so I know that atomic 17 is for chlorine, so it is a chlorine atom. And also you can also find out the structure of the atom. So this is what you can know from the atomic structures. The next one we are having is the isotopes. So isotopes are a kind of elements wherein the atoms has got the same atomic number but different atomic mass number due to the different number of neutrons present in them. So isotopes are atoms of the same element having same atomic number but different mass numbers. Elements like chlorine will be having isotope 35Cl17 or 37Cl17. So atomic number is same, 17, 17 each, but mass number is 35 and 37. So electrons are 17, 17 each, protons are 17, 17 each, but the neutrons are different, that is 18 in the first case and 20 in the next case. So properties of isotopes, isotopes are similar chemical properties, because the chemical properties are dependent upon the electrons present in the atoms. Because chemical properties, kaise hota hai? Chemicals are formed by the inter-exchanging of the electrons. Kyunki dono mein number of electrons are the same, so isotopes will have the same atomic, chemical properties. Isotopes will be having the same chemical properties, because the chemical properties is dependent on the electrons. Whereas the physical properties like weight wagera, kyunki neutrons jada hai, toh weight uska jada ho gaya, toh automatically physical quantities will be, physical properties will be different. So chemical properties of isotopes of the same elements are similar. Chemical properties are dependent on electronic configuration of the atom. Isotopes have the same atomic number, same number of electrons, and have same electronic configuration. Hence, the chemical properties of the isotopes are same or similar. Chemical properties of the isotopes are same or similar. The physical properties of the isotopes of same elements are different. So physical constants are different on the atomic mass. So of course atomic mass itself is different. So physical properties different honge. So isotopes have different atomic mass, different number of neutrons, hence different atomic masses. So number of neutrons, electrons and protons of isotopes are same. So that's why we see that the in the isotope, the physical properties are going to be different, but the chemical properties are going to be the same. Examples of isotopes. Many elements exist in isotopic forms. Hydrogen has got 3 isotopes, that is protium, deuterium and tritium. Carbon has got 3, C12, C13 and C14. Oxygen has got 3, O16, O17 and O18.
So oxygen, they are given the conditions over there. Chlorine has got 235 and 37. Potassium has got 239 and 41. Uranium has got 2, which is 235 and 238. The atomic mass of chlorine is a fraction and not a whole number. Now this again is a question which we studied in the part of the language of chemistry mein, ke why is the atomic number of chlorine is a decimal point or not in whole numbers. So it is this way, the atomic number in mass is the ratio of the mass of the average of all the isotopes of an element to the mass of 1/12 of the carbon atom, C12 6 atom. Chlorine exists in two forms, Cl3517 and Cl3717. So approximately one atom out of each every four of out is 37 Cl. So hence the mass of one atom of 37 Cl is 37, and the three atoms is 35, which is 105. So the total of four masses is 142, and the average becomes 35.5. So the relative, we can say the atomic mass is the ratio of the masses of the average of the isotopes. And that's the reason, due to the formation of the average over here, the average of the isotopes ka mass ka, chlorine ka kitna hota hai, 35.5. So that's why atomic mass of chlorine is 35.5. Now we see the reactivity, chemical reactivity of an atom due to the octet rule. So what exactly happens is, why is this particular valency important, and how is this valency is going to make the atom more active or reactive in nature? So that is what we are going to study in this part of the chapter. There is noble gases are stable electronic configuration, that is their valence shells is complete. They do not gain, lose or share electrons. Their atoms are extremely unreactive. Noble gases, exception helium, has 8 electrons in the outermost shell, arrangement known as octet. So we very well know that the noble gases has got the electronic configuration which is 2,2, which is completing the, 2, which is completing the orbit, 2,8, which is completing the orbit, and 2,8,8 will be again completing its outermost orbit. So because its outermost orbit is complete, that's why they are unreactive in nature. These particular elements are unreactive, and because of their presence, because of their completing their octet rule. The octet rule is completed, so they have completed their 8 electrons. In case of helium, it has completed the duplet rule, that is the 2 electrons in the outermost shell. Helium has 2 electrons in the outermost shell, arrangement known as duplet. The octet and the duplet element seems to be represent stability, and hence noble gases are almost inert to chemical reactions. So because of the stability, we can say that the atom is going to achieve stability by completing the duplet or octet rule. So if the octet and duplet rule are fulfilled, then the atom becomes stable. So that's why we have the different noble gases, as helium, which will be the electronic configuration just 2, neon, which is 2,8, argon 2,8,8, krypton is 2,18,8, xenon is 2,18,18,8, and radon is 2,8,18,32,18,8. So there are these are the different number of noble gases. So number of protons present was 2, 10, 18, 36, 54 and 86. So the reason for chemical stability of the chemical activity of the atom is unstable electronic configuration. The atom of element other than noble gases are assumed to have unstable electronic configuration. Attaining stable electronic configuration, the driving force in combining of atom is related to the tendency for them to attain a stable electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas. So each and every element will be striving to attain the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas. So if you see the nearest noble gas over here, so isko kya karna hai, isko apne 3 electrons de dena and become like this, so it become 2. Isko kya karna hai, isko apne 4 electrons aur lena and become like 2,8. Okay, this one wants to give away its electron and become 2,8. This one wants to gain one electron and become 2,8,8. So always the atom will have a tendency to accept or donate or share the electrons with other elements so that their electronic configuration is stable. So to have a stable electronic configuration, that means to have a complete octet on the in the outermost orbit, they will always strive to do that thing, and that causes the chemical reactions to take place. So attaining the driving force in combining of atom is related to the tendency for them to attain a suitable a stable electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas. So the achieve the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas is the way a stability is going to be achieved by a particular atom. So that's the octet rule. For an atom to achieve stable electronic configuration, it must have two electrons in its first shell, like that of the noble gases helium, that is duplet rule, and 8 electrons in the outermost shell, like that of noble gases other than helium, octet rule. Thus, chemical combination atoms involve redistribution of electrons so as to leave each atom with a stable electronic configuration. So the main thing is that the chemical combination, what does the chemical combination result into? The chemical combination results into having a stable electronic configuration after the electrons have been transferred or received from some other. So redistribution of the electrons. So after the redistribution of the electrons, if the atom is attaining a stable electronic configuration, that is the main thing what is called as the octet rule. So octet rule, atoms tend to achieve stable electronic configuration by having 8 electrons in their outermost shell, like that of noble gases other than helium, because of the 2 electron duplet rule. So for attaining chemical activity by an atom, so first is by transferring one or more electrons from one atom to another, the atom formed are thus positively or negatively charged and are called as ions. Loss of electrons result in the atoms attaining an overall positive charge, while gain of electrons result in atom attaining an overall negative charge. The electronic theory of the oxidation and reduction is based on the loss and gain of electrons, where oxidation is a process when an atom or an ion loses electrons. So Fe2 plus minus electrons will give you Fe3 plus, and reduction is the process when an atom of ion or ion gains electron, then Fe3 plus plus electron gives you Fe2 plus. So what they mean to say is that electrons, when they are lost by any particular atom, when an atom loses its electrons, so what is happening? So like for example over here, let's say Na. Na has got 11 protons and electrons, so that's why it is electrically neutral. But agar is ye electron mein 11 mein se ek electron chala jayega, so what is the number of electrons now? 10. And what is the number of protons? Still 11. So that means the Na becomes positively charged. So when an atom loses electron, it becomes a positively charged ion. And when it gains electron, like in case of chlorine, it will gain electrons, so it will be 18 electrons, whereas protons are still 17, and it will become negatively charged. So when an atom gains electron, it is going to be negatively charged. When it is going to lose electron, it is going to be positively charged. Now gain of electron is called as oxidation. So when it's called, say that the theory of oxidation and reduction is such that when an ion or an atom is going to gain electron, it is oxidation, and when it loses electron, it is called as reduction. So they give the example over here that Fe2 plus, when it loses electron, it becomes Fe3 plus, and this loss of electron is called as oxidation. Okay, loss of electron, oxidation. Gain of electron, that will Fe2 plus electron will become Fe3 plus, it is reduction. So reduction is gain of electrons. And the other way the chemical can attain a chemical atom can attain a stability is by sharing of electrons. So by sharing one or more electrons, electron pairs between the two combining atoms. So this is how the atoms can attain stability, either by donating electrons, accepting electron, that is by oxidation or reduction, or by means of sharing of electrons. So there are some examples given over here, but I will continue that example in the next video.